Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Skyrim. I know I said I would do a side video every 3 to 4 entries in this one, and that's going to be the overall pattern, but my first side project's going to be Alien Isolation, and I really do want to I want to have my normal voice back, because I'm doing that one blind, and it's all about capturing my reactions, so we'll do another Skyrim video for now. You'll recall that we left off as soon as this starts working at the Guardian Stones, having cleared out some wilderness around Riverwood, and I mentioned that our next target was going to be this hunter down here. And that is, in fact, the case. Let's just roll down and say hello. We'll talk to him first. He isn't hostile, but you'll notice we don't get a bounty if we attack him. It's because he's an outlaw. He's a poacher, stealing from the Jarl. And just like that, we hit level 6. It's another health level. I still have no alchemy perks available. Well, no crafting perks. So let's get into stealth land. Oh, we can grab backstab, but it won't do me any good until we switch to one-handed. Grab muffled movement, because that'll actually help me move. Help me sneak successfully. Because noise from armor is reduced 50%. Let me just make note of all that really quick. Be ready to go soon. Alrighty. Oh, goodness. There. Now we're working correctly. We'll talk to him first.
I've been hunting and fishing in these parts for years. It's not like my poaching is hurting anyone. The Jarl can hardly eat every deer now, can he? There's enough for all of us if you aren't greedy.
Oh, that's good tea.
Need something?
All right, that's all he's got.
Until next time.
Next, I want to pick his pockets. He's got a bear pelt, which I need, and that'll raise my pickpocket to 20. Cool. Sorry, just have to tend to my lists. This will become less and less tedious as things are eliminated from the lists, of course. Cooked beef. 3 goat hide. Now, goat hides are actually on the list. I need 8 of them. So when I take these 3, that number will be down to 5.
You could have. I guess I can.
Come on, let's have it. There we go. 1.
I saw you. What are you doing? What are you doing?
2.
You could have. You could have. I guess.
3. Perfect. Let's get his gold.
I saw you.
I mean, we're gonna get everything, let's be real. Let's get his arrows. That raises pickpocket to 21. Very good.
What are you doing?
Leg of goat. 3 lockpicks. Get his longbow.
I saw you.
Get his Nord mead.
I saw you.
Ring of Minor Archery is going to be tough to steal.
I saw you.
I only have a 1 in 20 chance, so this will take a while. But we definitely want the Fortify Archery enchanting effect. Bam! Pickpocket increased to 25. There you go. It's got 4 venison.
I guess.
What are you doing?
And he's got 1 wolf pelt. Which I'll go ahead and take off the list, because I know I'm going to get it. Need 7 more now. Or, after I get this one, I'll need 7 more.
You could have. I saw you. I guess.
Oh, come on, you're killing me. There we go. 1 more. Perfect. Pickpocket to 26 to boot. Alright. Now let's kill him.
You never should have come here.
Enough! This ends now!
Victory's your...
2-handed to 31. Outstanding. We barely survived, but I wouldn't want it any other way. Restoration to 17. Lo and behold, another level up. We'll make this one a health level as well. So I could get backstab. But in terms of stuff that'll actually help me now, I think I'll be better off grabbing Light Fingers 1 out of the pickpocket tree. So that's what I'm going to do. I eventually work my way up to extra pockets just because carry weight is so annoying. You all know, I'm sure. Alright. Take the rest of his stuff. Steal all his salmon. His mead, his coin purse. And the real thing to do is pick this lock. Iron gauntlets, baby. Finally, heavy armor. See, we can't take his fishing pole. He can take the oars out of the boat. You'll note that we got dragonflies here. Damn it. Thought he was just floating, but that one was running already. Oh, shoot. And that time I overshot the orange one. There, we got all 3. There's another set over here. I missed one. Got all 3. Let's check for fish now. There's a set. And there's another set. Awesome. And we got more salmon, too. Hooray. Alright, now, before we leave, there's an iron ore vein over here at his camp. Gotta make sure we get all that. Ah. Okay. Now we want to head across the river. And kind of search this plateau over here. Don't see anything, but you can usually find a low-level critter, like a wolf or a skeever. And there's the wolf. Heavy armor to 16. Perfect. Let's kill that wolf. Heal up. And let's take his pelt while we're at it. That's a fourth pelt inside this... No, I'm sorry, a second pelt in this video. And with it in hand, I only need six more. Good. And that should be it as far as critters. Let's just make sure we don't miss any thistle branches in this little expanse of land back here. What am I successfully sneaking from? I don't think I'm in range of Anise. There must be another critter somewhere. I don't see it. Do you see a thistle branch I almost missed? Well, no telling what it was, but maybe I am in range of Anise, who knows. Anyway, all we're doing now is kind of... Oh, an iron ore vein. Okay, with all that done, we should be ready to move in on the cabin. I already took the liberty of dealing with it on my lists, so let's start moving slow now. We don't have the silence perk yet. We just have muffled movement. Here's Anise's cabin. Something killed her already. Are you kidding me? Normally we have to fight her ourselves. Not today, I guess. Come here, Fox. Well, that's really odd. I wonder what killed her. I hear more wolves. Maybe it was them. Get back here. One more hit. Come on. Oh, come on. Oh, we're so close. Come on. There. We got the fox. Good. Let's turn around and deal with that wolf, or wolves. How many are there? Just one, looks like. How weird that Anise is already dead. I mean, it's good. I'd rather not have to fight her, because casters are incredibly tough to deal with, but... It's strange. The nice thing about fox pelts is that, paradoxically, the nice thing is I don't need any. They don't do me any good on their own, so I can go to a tanning rack and turn it into leather, which I do need. Okay, but seriously, what killed Anise? I guess it must have been that wolf, because he was so damaged. I'm really surprised a wolf would win that fight, but whatever, I'll take it. Saves me the hassle, that's for sure. Alright, so here's our house. Anise's cabin. our first house, anyway. Let's loot everything outside. There's actually some important stuff over here. Straw is something that we need for hearthfire. We need 32 of it. That number is now 30. Good. Let's take that. Let's grab the Petty Soul Gem, the Hagraven Feathers, the Purple Mountain Flower, and the Death Bell. Death Bell is important. We need 21 of them. One for one quest and 20 for another. So now that number's down to 20. Good. Let's head over here next. The Song of the Alchemists shows up on 3 of my lists, no surprise. Because it's a quest book. We need it for a lady in Morthal. Of course, it's a book. And, naturally, as a skill book, it's also one of my free skill boosts. So let me deal with my notes right quick. That's 2 down, 1 more. There we go. Okay, so let's grab that. Let's check her dresser now. Nothing important. Let's head into the cellar. Lockpicking went to 17. Good. Let's loot everything out of here. Hagraven Claw is on my gear checklist. You need one for a quest later on, so take it off the list and make note of it. There's a second Death Bell. So now I need 19 of those. Here's a letter from Anis, which is basically her admitting that she's a witch and trying to get her someone named Helgi, don't know who it is, I don't think you ever run into her, to come out and help her form a witch's coven. So pretty serious business. Good thing the wolves put a stop to that. Normally we do, but we didn't get the chance this time. Let's go ahead and steal everything else. Okay. Now let me show you. Well, hold up. Let me check my carry weight. It's pretty high. I kind of need to do this in two phases. This cupboard is where I like to stash stolen stuff. And as you can see, at least if it's something I just want to sell, and as you can see, Sky UI makes this ever so much easier. Okay, good. Now in here is where I like to stick wearables that I'm holding on to. So, you know, my best light armor, my best bow, and my best one-handed weapon would all go in that dresser. I don't have them on me right now. This is where I like to stick stuff that goes in the crafting loop. I don't think I'm carrying anything like that with me at the moment. But I'm gonna take a second to be certain. No, I'm not. This sack, right on top of it, is where I like to stick stuff that I need for various quests. So, bear pelt can go in there, death bell can go in there, goat hide for hearthfire, hagraven claw. Song of the Alchemists, the straw, and the wolf pelt can all go in there. This one is where I like to stick smithing supplies. So I'm going to hold on to the fox pelt, but iron ore can go in there. This should be obvious, since it's right next to the alchemy lab. It's a great place to stick your alchemy ingredients. This barrel is where I like to stick enchanting supplies, so I already have this sitting at home. The Ring of Minor Archery I'll be disenchanting, and I stick the empty soul gem in there to use later when I learn Soul Trap. And finally, this cupboard is where I stick unique items. We still can't smith, unfortunately, but we can do just about everything else. So now that we have an alchemy lab and an enchanting altar, let's have our first little crafting session. You'll notice me grabbing my iPhone. It's because I use the Skyrim Alchemy app, available for free on the App Store, to help me make sure that I get the best possible use out of all my alchemy ingredients. This is necessary, of course, because
the Riverwood Trader is every.
We want
some
alchemy to go up as
junk,
much as possible.
Me, I call them
so
treasure.
Let's sell him everything that I don't need to hold on to.
Damn thieves!
And let's go ahead and turn that fox pelt into our first little bit of leather. Now for the crafting loop, I need 8 leather. And this is our first one. That number down to 7. Perfect. So... Wait, we don't want to leave yet. Need to grab all our stuff out of this barrel. Yeah, baby. Okay, let's head to the Guardian Stones. Because the first thing I want to do is disenchant everything. And I want to get the most possible benefit to my enchanting skill from doing that. So I want to put on the Mage Stone, head back to Anissa's cabin. Any other stolen stuff I just want to sell can go in here, so that would be Horker attacks, these potions, Wolf Queen, and the weak version to magic. In here I want to stick my hunting bow, my steel sword, my hide shield, my iron shield, need some light gauntlets, shouldn't have gotten rid of those so fast. Okay, that's fine. Now I want to rest. Oh, it won't let me rest in the bed, which is weird because the owner's dead. Oh well. 5% doesn't make a big difference. Well, it spawns some stuff in there. We'll just head right up here with those. And try again now. Crafting loop stuff goes in here, so that would be my two fur gauntlets, my iron helmet, and I almost forgot, my Imperial Light helmet goes in here too. Not out here. Iron ingot and leather go in there. Rough spun tunic goes in there. Snowberries go in there, and I think that's it. This one gets Blackbriar Mead, Bear Pelt, Elk Hide, Mudcrab Chitin, Nightfalls on Sentinel, Nightshade, Nurn Root, Potion of Minor Healing, Small Antlers, and Wolf Pelts. This one gets gems and ore. Alchemy ingredients go in here, of course. Woodsman's Friend goes in here. It's the only unique item I've found so far. Now, let's leave the Petty Soul Gem where it is, but let's get out the Ring of Minor Archery. Let's go disenchant some stuff. Hooded Thalmor Robes. That gives me Fortified Destruction. So that'll show up on two lists. My Enchanting Effects list, and well, that's it, but, it will help me, as you can see, raise my enchanting pretty quick, actually. Iron Helmet of Minor Illusion gives me Fortify Illusion. Pretty good. Novice Hood gets us Fortify Magicka, and bonus raises Enchanting to 21. So you'll note some Enchanting perks have become available. Novice Robes give us Fortify Magicka Regen, and raise Enchanting to 22. Pretty cool. Ring of Minor Archery gives us Fortify Archery and raises Enchanting to 23. And the Ring of Minor Sneaking raises Enchanting to a whopping 26 while teaching us Fortify Sneak. I think that's going to be enough to level up. And with 26 Enchanting, my perk will be Enchanter 2. Because I now meet the minimum. Like I said, if a crafting perk is available, it always takes top priority. Because the crafting perks are what make legendary survivable. So level 8 is a health level. And sure enough, we can now take Enchanter 2, and we will. It's alchemy time now. We want to put the Thief Stone back on for that. So let me go do that right quick. These crafting sessions may seem tedious, but they're by far the most important thing you can do in terms of powering up your character. I just heard some clanking metal somewhere. I think maybe it wasn't a wolf that killed Anise. Like there's a bandit corpse around somewhere. Yeah, look, a dead skeleton. Two dead skeletons. The hell did she get in a fight with? Three dead skeletons, jeez. Not only that, but the ancient Nord Greatsword is better than our Iron Greatsword. How odd. Well, now I guess we know what killed her. Three skeletons, but that's gotta be a random encounter. So even though it's gone, let me check my list right quick. Might have been Vigilance fighting skeletons. Who's this down here? I don't actually want to clear this encounter. I just want to see if it's a Vigilant of Stendar. Because if it is, then I know which encounter we got. It is! So the random encounter Vigilance fighting skeletons happened. What do you know? And apparently, dear Anise got caught in the crossfire.
You speak to a Vigilant of Stendar. Cavort with any Daedra, and we will hunt you down.
So I guess we better talk to this guy.
Walk always in the light, or we will drag you to it. Wherever the Daedra hide, the Vigil of Stendar will cast them into the light. None escape the Vigil. All come into the light. Stendar's mercy be upon you, for the Vigil has none to spare.
Just trying to get all his...
Walk always in the
statements.
Light, or we will drag you to...
You're a Vigilant of Stendar?
Yes. Our order was founded after the Oblivion Crisis. We dedicate our lives to facing the threat of Daedra wherever they appear. We're quartered in the Hall of the Vigilant. Keeper Karset heads Skyrim's branch of our order there, providing healing and justice as needed.
Stendar.
The god of mercy, the patron of order and justice for all of Tamriel. We bring his compassion where none can be found, by cleansing all those who would offend his children.
You hunt Daedra?
And any other abominations that prey on mortals. Vampires, werewolves, witches. But the Daedra are the worst. Their callous disregard for our lives is abhorrent in the eyes of the God of Mercy.
Maybe he killed Anise. What's dangerous about Daedra?
They are profane creatures with no hope of redemption. They lure innocents to their death, and corrupt the souls of all they touch. And their heretical artifacts grant powers to mortals that wreak havoc across Tamriel. They must be destroyed or guarded to prevent temptation.
All right.
None escape the vigil. All come into the...
No, he's not an outlaw, so... We'll just pick his pocket and then be on our way. I'm gonna leave his torch, because... For whatever reason, you can't ever sell them and they don't work right. But I'll take his belted tunic. I'll take his potions of healing. Now, if you have Dawnguard installed, you actually want to keep a potion of cure disease with you, much like the Haunting Brew Mead. Because there will be a random encounter with a hunter who had been attacked by a vampire and infected, and you can only help him if you've got the potion on you, so... We'll take that. Pickpocket to 27, not bad. And we'll take that note, too. Potion recipe, resist poison. Potion recipes can be hard to find, so... Pretty exciting to find one on his person. And take that off my book list and make note of it. Pickpocket to 27, that's nice. Resist poison potion. Thistle and Falmer ear. Alright. Well, good. Mystery solved. We know what killed Anise. I'm not certain if she got in a fight with the skeletons, the wolves, or the Vigilant, but I'm guessing the Vigilant probably killed her, since she is a witch, and he just told me that they hunt witches. Okay. If the ancient Nord sword is better than the steel sword or not. 9 damage versus 9 damage. I'm gonna say no. Well, now, before I make potions, I've got a few things to sell. Let's go do that, shall we? I think our first alchemy session will probably occupy the rest of the video, so if you want to skip it and just check the description
for
how far along I get and every effect I earn, that would be fine with me. I would understand not wanting to wait through it.
Damn thee!
Okay. Let me make sure I have the Thief Stone on. I think I do. Yes. So let's head back to the cabin now. Okay, so first thing you need to do, I'll tell you how to use the app, how it works. You need to put in your skills and your perks. So right now my skill is 16 because of the one skill book I found, and I have Alchemist 1. Then you need to put in all the ingredients you have. So 2 Abishan long fin, 1 bear claw, 2 bees, 2 beehive husk, 12 blue dart wing, 22 blue mountain flower, 5 bone meal, 2 butterfly wing, 4 ceratilic spade tail, 1 elf's ear, 2 frost mirium, 3 garlic, 1 grass pod, 2 hagraven feathers, 1 hanging moss, 7 hist carp, 1 honeycomb, 8 moritapanella, 2 Nordic barnacle, 9 orange dart wing, 2 pine thrush egg, 19 purple mountain flower, 22 red mountain flower, 3 river betty, 4 rock warbler egg, 6 salmon roe, 17 salt pile, 3 silverside perch, 3 skeever tail, 3 slaughterfish egg, 7 spider egg, 42 thistle branch, 1 torchbug thorax, 1 wheat, 4 white cap, and 1 wisp wrappings. And then you just click the sell button, and based on all of the info, it'll calculate the most valuable potions you can make. So behold, shit's about to get crazy. Use garlic, Nordic barnacle, and salmon roe. Alchemy jumps all the way to 17 on a single potion. Not only that, but look at all the effects we learned. So, for garlic, I learned regenerate magicka and regenerate health. For Nordic barnacle, I learned water breathing and regenerate health. And for salmon roe, I learned regenerate magicka and water breathing. And let me make note of all those things. Regenerate magicka and water breathing. Nordic barnacle, we got regenerate health and water breathing. And garlic, we got regenerate magicka and regenerate health. Cool. And alchemy raised to 17. Do it one more time. Oh, that was awesome. Next, we're gonna go garlic, hist carp, salmon roe. It'll be almost as good. So first, on salmon roe, we learned restore stamina and fortify magicka, which means we've learned all 4 effects for it already. And for hist carp, we got 3 on this first potion. We got water breathing, fortify magicka, and restore stamina. Very cool. Let me make note of it here. Salmon roe is off my list already since I learned all 4. Hist carp, we're at 3 out of 4. The only one missing is damage stamina regen. And alchemy went to 18. Not bad. Next. Histcarp, salt pile, salmon roe. That gets us regenerate magicka on salt pile. Still three more effects to track down, but that's alright. One more of those raised alchemy to 19. Very good. Alright, things are going to settle down now that we're out of Salmon Row. Next, we're going to go Bear Claws, Butterfly Wing, Hanging Moss. Well, I might be wrong about things settling down. So, let's start with Hanging Moss. We learned Damage Magicka, Fortify Health, Fortify One-Handed, and Damage Magicka Regen. We learned all four effects in one potion. Pretty baller. For Butterfly Wing, we learned Damage Magicka, and that's it. And for Bear Claws, we learned Fortify Health, Fortify One-Handed, Damage Magicka Regen. Only missing one. Oh, Hanging Moss is off the list. Pretty good. Excuse me. Butterfly Wing, we only got one effect. That's alright, though. And Bear Claws, we got three. The only one we're missing is the most basic one, Restore Stamina. And, to boot, that got Alchemy to 20. Means our next perk will be Alchemist 2. Alright, next we're gonna go River Betty, Salt Pile, Wisp Wrappings. Got a few there. So, Wisp Wrappings, we learned Fortify Carry Weight. For Salt Pile, we learned Slow. It's the second one on it. We have two more to find. And for River Betty, we learned Slow and Fortify Carry Weight. Outstanding. And alchemy went to 21. I'm sorry, I know this is pretty tedious. But we'll reap the rewards in spades once alchemy hits 100. There's 21 alchemy. Next, we're going to go Frost Miriam, Purple Mountain Flower, and Wheat. We learned a lot. So, on Wheat, we got Lingering Damage Magicka, and Damage Stamina Regen. On Purple Mountain Flower, we learned Lingering Damage Magicka, Resist Frost, and Fortify Sneak. And on Frost Miriam, we learned Resist Frost, Fortify sneak and damage stamina regen. I need to do that in both places. So wheat, we got lingering damage magicka and damage stamina regen. It's the one we only had two on. Purple mountain flower, we got 3 out of 4. The only one we're missing is the most basic one, restore stamina. And for frost Miriam, we are missing ravage magicka, the fourth one there. Alright, next we are going to go Red Mountain Flower, River Betty, Salt Pile. That was a little less dramatic than the last one. On River Betty we learned Damage Health. And on Red Mountain Flower we learned Damage Health, and that's it. And alchemy went to 22. Good. So we'll make another one of those. Next, we're gonna go Blue Mountain Flower, Bone Meal, Spider Egg. Spider Egg, we get Damage Magicka Regen and Damage Stamina. Bone Meal, we get Fortify Conjuration and Damage Stamina. And on Blue Mountain Flower, we get Damage Magicka Regen and Fortify Conjuration. Very good. All right, lists are handled. One more of those is sufficient to raise alchemy to 23. Two more and alchemy hits 24. Next, we're gonna go Blue Mountain Flower, well, we got alchemy at 25, so the perk will be Alchemist too. And this is a stamina level, lest we forget. So we'll take Alchemist 2. I need to remove that from my build list as well. Awesome. Save and get back to it. I I think I miscounted some ingredients somewhere. Let me just fix that right quick. Blue Mountain Flower, Elves Ear. Should be 2 spider eggs left. No, we're out of spider eggs. Yikes. Yeah, one of my numbers was wrong. I'm sorry about that, but no worries. We can get it fixed. Okay, we're gonna go Frost Miriam. Hist Carp. Purple Mountain Flower. Which gets us... I think we've used both of those before. Gets us Restore Stamina on Purple Mountain Flower. Which should take it off the list entirely. And it gets us Damage Stamina Regen on Hist Carp. Which also take it off the list entirely. Cool. Yep, we've got everything on Purple Mountain Flower. Good news indeed. And we've got everything on Hist Carp. Outstanding. Next, we're gonna go Grass Pod. Orange Dartwing Slaughterfish Egg. These are all new. So, Slaughterfish Egg. We get Lingering Damage Health, Resist Poison, Fortify Pickpocket. 3 out of 4. Orange Dartwing, we get Ravage Magicka, Fortify Pickpocket, Lingering Damage Health. 3 out of 4. And on Grass Pod. We get Resist Poison and Ravage Magicka. 2. And I gotta put those in another spot too, so just a second. And finally, Grass Pod. Next, Orange Dartwing, Slaughterfish Egg, and Torchbug Thorax. Which raises alchemy to 26. And of course, gives us new stuff. On Slaughterfish Egg, we got Fortify Stamina, which is its final effect, so it's off the list. Orange Dartwing, we got Restore Stamina. It's also off the list. Pretty great. And then on Torchbug Thorax, which is new, we got Restore Stamina and Fortify Stamina. 2 out of 4. Okay. Alchemy to 26. Next we go Beehive Husk, Orange Dart Wing, Slaughterfish Egg. And we get Resist Poison on Beehive Husk. Which was a new one. That's the first effect we learn. Next, we go B, Mora Tapanella, and Orange Dartwing. B and Mora Tapanella are both new. So on Mora Tapanella, we got Lingering Damage Health and Regenerate Stamina. And on B, we got Restore Stamina and Regenerate Stamina. Outstanding. And two of those is enough to make Alchemy 27. Good. Next, we go Purple Mountain Flower, Silver Spide Perch, and Skeever Tail. Two new ones there. Silverside Perch, we learn all four. That makes it easy. Skeever Tail, we learn Ravage Health and Damage Stamina Regen. 2 out of 4. Good. And I can make 3 of those. Next, we're gonna go Beehive Husk, Purple Mountain Flower, and Thistle Branch. Which gets me Fortify Sneak on Beehive Husk. And Thistle Branch, I think, is new. We get Resist Frost and Resist Poison. Now we've been going an hour, but I do want to finish this session, and I'm getting close. Let's go. Oh, and that raises Alchemy to 28. I almost missed it. Next up has to process a second. We want to go Blue Dartwing, Orange Dartwing, Pine Thrush Egg. So on Pine Thrush Egg, well, let's start with Blue Dartwing. It's new. We get Fortify Pickpocket and Resist Shock. 2 out of 4. Pine Thrush Egg, I think, is also new. To me, at least. We get Restore Stamina and Resist Shock. 2 out of 4. Very good. And I can make 2 of those. Next, we go Abishan Longfin, Cyrodiilic Spadetail, Purple Mountain Flower. I think those are both new. Cyrodiilic Spadetail, we got Fortify Restoration, one out of four. And Abishan Longfin, we got Fortify Sneak and Fortify Restoration, two out of four. And they were both new. Outstanding. And I can make two of those. Next, Cyrodiilic Spadetail, Rock Warbler Egg, Salt Pile. Alright, I know Salt Pile isn't new, but we got its last two effects, Fortify Restoration and Weakness to Magic, which will take it off the list. Very good. Cyrodiilic Spadetail, we learned damage stamina, 2 out of 4. And Rock Warbler Egg, which was new, we learned damage stamina and weakness to magic. Two out of four. And we got alchemy to 29. I can make two of those as well. Getting close. Blue Dartwing, Mora Tapanella, Orange Dartwing. No new effects. Blue Mountain Flower, Butterfly Wing, Hagraven Feathers. Okay, that gets us a few. I think Hagraven Feathers are the only new one. We got Damage Magicka and Fortify Conjuration. Blue Mountain Flower, I know we've used, and we got Restore Health on it. That's 3 out of 4. And Butterfly Wing, we got Restore Health, which is only 2 out of 4. It's alright though. Yes, Graven Feathers, there it is. Butterfly Wing, there it is. And Blue Mountain Flower. There it is. And I could only do one of those anyway. Next, Purple Mountain Flower, Thistle Branch, White Cap. See, White Cap is the only new one. We got Fortify Heavy Armor. We know we've done the Thistle Branch. There it is. We got Fortify Heavy Armor. That's 3 out of 4. Rip down to White Cap. Grab that one. Rip up to Thistle Branch. Grab that one. And I can make a whopping 4 of these. May boost me to 30, I don't know. It does, good. Alright, our next two perks will go in alchemy, because now we can get Physician and Benefactor. We're gonna go honeycomb, purple mountain flower, thistle branch. Gets me ravaged stamina on thistle branch, which is its fourth and final effect. Excuse me. Honeycomb is new. We got restore stamina and ravage stamina. Two out of four. And I could only do one of those. Alright, next we go Histcarp, purple mountain flower, thistle branch. No new effects, good. Next, blue dartwing, blue mountain flower, graven feathers. We get restore health on blue dartwing. Puts it at 3 out of 4. Not bad. And that was the only one I could do there. Alright, purple mountain flower and thistle branch. Four of those. Blue dartwing, rock warbler egg, salt pile. Gets me restore health on rock warbler egg. That's 3 out of 4 for it. And I can make 2 of those. Mora Tapanella and Red Mountain Flower. We get Restore Magicka on each of those. It's 3 out of 4 on Mora Tapanella. And 2 out of 4 on Red Mountain Flower. And I can make 4 of those. And we can go Elf's Ear and Red Mountain Flower. Elf's Ear is new. The only thing we learn is Restore Magicka. 1 out of 4. And last, we're gonna go Blue Dartwing, Blue Mountain Flower. No new effects. And we are done with our first alchemy session. So it's been a bit over an hour, so I'll hold off offloading next time. Until next time. Let me just put my ingredients away. And note that next thing we need to do is sell all this to Lucan, which will really help boost our speech skill. But we will do that next time on Let's Play Skyrim. Until then, I want to thank you very much for watching and wish you a fantastic day. Bye-bye.